As an engineer, you can't afford to be slow. You can't afford to be slow in designing. You can't afford to be slow in reporting. You can't afford to be slow in creating civil 3D objects. In our previous video, we explored ways in which we can boost our efficiency in civil 3D. And one of the ways was actually in dealing with surfaces. Surfaces can be very heavy. Here under the extended properties, you can see this is a very large surface. In 2D, it's 131 million square meters, and in 3D, it's 132 million square meters. So this is a very large surface, and sometimes you may be working on a particular part of the surface, not the entire surface. And one of the ways of boosting your efficiency while working with such a surface, you can either reduce the level of detail as we saw in our previous video. So for example, if I click on that surface and the contextual tab shows up here on the ribbon, I can reduce the level of detail. And as you can see, this is a surface in which the level of detail is reduced. I get to see the level of detail when I zoom in, but if I zoom out, I only see a few contours. So if I want it back to a high level of detail, I can do so. But there's another way of boosting your efficiency also. So let's say you're just working on a portion of the surface, and when you execute your commands, you edit your surface. Sometimes it can slow down your process because it's computing the entire surface. So if you're working on a particular surface, let's say just an isolated part of the surface as your site, how do you crop this surface so that you work on that part only? So if you click on that surface again and the contextual tab shows up, let me just escape again. Let me click on the surface, and here you can see the contextual tab up here. So here under the surface tools panel, there's a command called extract from surface. And here on top is a create cropped surface option. So you click on that and a warning shows up, a warning that is telling you the drawing must be saved before this command can be used. Just close that, then save the surface. Then click on the surface again, go back to extract from surface, click on create cropped surface, and this window pops up. And the first portion here is to select the crop area. So you have the surface to crop, which is the existing surface. We've already selected it. And then select crop area. So I just come here and click on this part here. And I want to select this portion for now. You just left click and you do not drag, you leave, and then you click on the other edge of your crop area. Then we are done with the crop information. So the next portion is the new surface. So where do we want to create our new surface? Is it in a new drawing? Is it in the existing drawing? Or is it in an open drawing? So I want to create it in a new drawing. So I select the first option. And then I get to select a template for the drawing that will be created, the new drawing that will be created. So I select this Australia and New Zealand template. And I click open. And then down here, I can give it a name. So for now, it will be named surface and then a number. Then the surface style, I can also select a surface style from the template that I just selected. So here, I just select that one and I click OK. And then I can assign a layer as well. So let it go to the zero layer for now. You can create your own layer if you want to. So you can see here, there's a new option there. And then I click OK. So let's go to the drawing and see whether it was created. So let's double click on our roller mouse. There we go. There we have our surface that we've created. Let's explore the surface. Right click, go to Object Viewer. There we go. And here now, when you create your objects, when you do your site design, it becomes easier and faster and more efficient instead of manipulating objects in this larger surface. Let's see the statistics of this surface. Let's see how big it is or how small it is. Surface properties. Let's go to the statistics tab. And now you can see this is a far smaller surface than the original surface. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 2 million square meters instead of the larger 131 million square meter surface. So this is how you boost your efficiency, make your work faster as an engineer. If you like the content, please remember to like and to subscribe, and please also comment on how you can boost your efficiency in Civil 3D. What are some of the ways that you've tried? What are some of the ways that you can also enlighten me so that I can also continue improving? So it's all about improving. It's all about excellence, and excellence is about improving every time you do your work. It's not about perfection. It's about improving. So see you in the next video. Remember to like, remember to subscribe, remember to share the content. Thank you.